Today I'm here with Dr. Blair. Talked about fetal programming and the effects on carcass and meat characteristics. Can you kind of tell everybody what fetal programming is and why producers need to be thinking about it?
Sure. Fetal programming is kind of this concept that the gestational environment can exert permanent and long-term impacts on the developing fetus. So, you know, the idea that there can be changes occur in gene expression even during gestation based on the environmental changes that could occur to a cow. And from a producer standpoint, I think this is really kind of a new and exciting area because it may give us additional management tools to be able to alter the composition or even the age to puberty, heifer development characteristics, all kinds of different things that different researchers are looking at. But in particular, our group is interested in how it could impact long-term body composition of that individual and ultimately affect the carcass quality or yield grade. Our main goal is to increase the amount of high-quality beef. We're really interested in, you know, can we manipulate maternal diet to have impacts on the deposition of fat or the development of muscle? Both of those tissues begin to develop during mid-gestation, ultimately going to become the product that consumers eat. And if any way we can manipulate more to a favorable meat product, whether that be more marbling or higher yields, that's kind of our ultimate goal, is to figure out some of those management strategies that could be utilized in that regard. One study that we have going on right now at the Antelope Research Station is looking at mineral nutrition and how copper and zinc availability can impact calf development and subsequent health, feedlot performance, and ultimately carcass characteristics. We also just started another project at the Cottonwood Research Station where we're looking at restricting protein during mid-gestation to see if there's impacts, again, on carcass composition, but we're mostly interested in looking at potential impacts on fetal muscle development. So by restricting protein in the cows, is there a change in fetal muscle development? So those two projects are ongoing at this time.